Hi, in this session I am going to create the two-dimension report for line item data. Now I am going to show you how to create directly from the FDI0. So to create the line item report using the line item analysis, right click on the 002 and it will pop up with a new window. You can click on create report, and here you can see this is directly selected the line item. So I am choosing the 3 and line item report, and now I am going to create the report as well as form directly without going to the separate transactions. So now you can see how to create the form, and if you directly click create button for the report, then the system will pop up. The form is not created, so we need to create the form first. So to create the form first, we just click on here, create the form. So it will go to the transaction what we have created previously to the FDI4, and you can see here this is under FDI4. The system automatically take you to the form creation transaction code. So now I will show you how to create a two axis matrix report. First the form, and you can click on create. So here you see the difference between the previous report what we created for balance and this report. So previously we can see here element 1 to 4, but now you can see here row 1 to 4 and column 1 to 4. So the default system will show you the 4 columns and 4 rows for any report. So now I am going to select the column 1 as a business area and column rows is a customer. So I'm just selecting characteristics with a key figure. Why it is showing the characteristic and key figure with characteristics and predefined element? Because the first one we are selecting here. For example, if you are already selected a characteristic called customer here, for example, I choose and the customer from, I'm creating my own variable and the customer to. So click check and save. Now if you click on the column here, the system will pop. You previously show 3 radio buttons, now it will show only 2, because you are already selected one dimension, which is a characteristic here. So now you need to select the key figure with characteristics here, which is, now there's an amount here. You don't have any option, you just need to select amount in local currency, and now I'm choosing the business area. Sorry, and here from the business area I'm selecting 0001 to 5000. Check and save. So I just choose my description. Copy text for all. I just want to use the same, and here I would like to copy the same for all the other columns and select this block, and you click on here copy. So it will copy how many rows you want. So I'm just selecting and then copy, click on copy, and selecting, click on copy. So for example, okay, you accidentally selected the another one, you want to delete the particular one, select and delete and click yes, then system will delete. So now I double click here, I'm just going to change the business area 5001 and this one is 9000. Click save. So I need to change the text as well, and 5001 9000. Copy. So it will copy all the same text. And now I double click on the third row, which I choose 9001 and 999. Copy, save, and click on save. So now you already selected columns and rows. So now I'm going to check the report. Click on check. You see all others, if you are not selected any dimensions like a characteristics or a key figures in the any blank columns, that will be system automatically going to delete. So you no need to manually delete. When you click on check or if you click on save, then the system is going to delete automatically. So now you click on save, this form is saved. So now you go back, now you go back to the previous screen, which is FDI 1, which is a report creation. Now I'm going to create a line item report. So now the form I was created form already. So now I'm going to create a report using the same form. So to create the report using the same form, we just click on create. And here you can see there's a lot of options available, characteristics here, and you can choose account type, accounting class, business area, company code, country, and the customer, document type, industry. Yes, so all these I am selecting now. And the account type here is only the D. So it's customer. So my reporting is USD. So click save. And I forgot to select the other options. Now I go to the click create. Click on change. So now I'm going to right click on the report and change, because I only selected the characteristics. I have not selected anything on variables or output or options. So now come to the variables, and here I choose 1, 2 and output type I usually select only this one, and the drill down and the available selection screen I selected. So these options, yes, it's mass printing, how you want the print. And you want all the dimensions to be printed or only the display report to be printed, you can select the mass settings. Under the mass select settings, and click on save. So now I'm going to execute the report. Now give the company code, because I defaultly selected these customers. And now the open item key date is this one. Click on execute. Now you can see the system as showing the report, which is accounting clerk by business area. So you can see so whether this business area report is correct or not, you can see, because you are already selected the business areas in the columns. So now if you select on the rows, so to select on the rows you have to click on that business area and click here, then the system will choose. So you can easily see the range what we have selected, 0001 to 5000 is under first column, it's perfectly showing here, and 5001 to 9000, which is showing on the second column, and from 9001 to 9999, which is showing under third column. So you can see, yes, finally there this report, yeah, looks fine based on our selections. So now you can click on the customer and click on the business area here, then the system will show by the customer and the business area. So this is, you can see there's a lot of customers and there's a lot of open items. So for example, okay, now you are selecting the country and you can see Canada and Germany and the US. So for example, only you are interested in the Germany, and which is under the business area, and you want to see the line items. So this will be applicable for both balance as well as line item reports. You can drill down to the line item data. So you can select this particular cell and then go to the extras and click on the line items. So now system is going to get the data which is relating to the Germany and within this business area for all the open items. So it's taking some time to get the data. If you have a huge data, I don't recommend to click on the line item data, because yeah, you can cross check with any other particular reports, or you can create your own variant with the summarized data in the FBL5, and so then when you select, then defaultly that layout will be chosen by the system. So now I just switch the layout. So I cannot switch the layout here, and yes, you can see here. Sorry. Yeah, these are the data you can see. This is having the business area. $9,000. So for example, let me add here, and otherwise I choose the other layout, which is best one as standard local currency. Yes, this is the best layout you can choose, and now you just add the business area. And you add the business area. Now I want to add the country or city. Let me add the city because I don't have the country. City don't have any data. So yes, we need to trust this data. If you see this one and you don't have, but how to get the country, if you go to this customer and you can go how the system is getting this data, you can go to that customer level information and see this customer is assigned to the country code DE. Yes, you see, this is a customer is assigned to the DE, so system is getting the data based on the customer master country code and also the line item data by business area. So this is how the data extracted by the system. So you can drill down the reports using this option. So here we have selected so many items. If you want to see the industry, you can click on the industry here. So this is the industry by business area division. For example, if you double click on here, then you can see the detailed values by the industry. So for example, if you want to see the data by this industry and by this business area and by individual customer, so you can check. So you can keep changing this industry, so data will be automatically updated. For example, if you want by business area, so you can select the business area and double click here. You don't want industry, then you can select the industry and click on the right arrow, so the system will automatically take this to this normal position. So this is how you can play with the report, and you can create your own reports using the SAP standard report painter tool for AR. So thank you for everyone. If you have any questions, please write to me. So I'm glad to detail you as far as I have the knowledge. And thank you for watching my videos. Thanks.